Hi everyone and welcome back. So in the previous video we write nested payload validation using class validator, and this is how it works. You can see the schema and you can see the example values, right? Address is of type array and it is having these two properties. Basic validation using the DTOs and the class validator and using validation pipe and using these nested, using these custom annotations, we are exposing the same things like name, age, address. These are required things. So we have to put a proper required flag in the Swagger annotations. Okay. Now, next thing we are going to talk properly is about Nest.js with the database. Okay, like type ORM, SQLize. These are different ORMs available. So Nest.js can talk to MongoDB using Mongoose. Nest.js can talk to Postgres, MySQL using type ORM. Nest.js can talk to Postgres and MySQL using SQLize or different other ORMs. What we are going to understand is how Nest.js can talk to MySQL or the Postgres using type ORM. Okay, so if you are totally new to this, then I will just suggest that you just go ahead and look into documentation, but it should be fairly simple. What I'm going to do is I'm going to write a custom module for the database, because when you are connecting to database you need username, password, port, database name, all and on the encoding of the database and the type, right? All these properties you need to connect to database, and here we are using ORM. ORM means the tables, and for the each and every tables we are going to write the entities. So here we have the entity table. This is your feature module, like we have a cat module, right? Feature module, and we have created a separate folder, DTO, services, controllers, pipes, or maybe entities. Inside entity you will define all your entities. So we are using type ORM, so it will be a type ORM contact entity. We'll talk about this in the detail, but this is a simple definition of a class. And it is using the multiple annotations like column, primary column, and all these things of different types. So we have created entities. Now, but how we connect to the database first, right? So we are using type ORM. For type ORM, I will write a database module as a separate. Then we will import the database module here. So inside, let's say, what I will do is inside SRC, we can create a database module. That database module will actually give us the type ORM initialization. Okay, so we can create a DB module inside app folder. Let's call it the database. And inside database, you can create a database.module.ts. Okay. Now this database module will give us, will initialize the type ORM configurations. And if you look into the documentation, then initializing the database with the type ORM is simple. So we'll go to the feature module, and this module will import a database module. Okay, so what we are going to do in our feature module first. So we will be writing a lot of entities. I mean, like contact entity, user entity, all these entities. And though these entities, we have to pass in the type ORM, say, okay, these are all the entities I have, and I'm going to do the find by ID, delete, update, all these operation on these set of entities. So first of all, let's gather all the entities. So I wrote a custom logic to get all the entities from a particular path. So in the entities, in the current folder, if you see the entity module, inside that we have a dot entity folder. Here we will put all our entities that we are getting here. Now if you look into the documentation of type ORM, type ORM provides these different like if I just import type ORM module, type ORM dot module dot, so it will give us all these methods, for root, for feature, right? All these methods. So we can use for root, but we are writing a custom module. If you see the for root, what it takes simply the type ORM connections, right? If you look into the documentation, type ORM module options, which are nothing but a host, port, database name, user, password, blah blah, and all these things, and entities. Similarly, this is the one thing to initialize the connection. And another thing is, we are going to do is for feature. What it does is, it says, okay, database connection, this type ORM database connection is available for all these entities we have. That's it. Now go to any services inside this module and access any repository. Like I have a user repository, contact repository, and then repository.find, find by ID, delete, all these operations you can do. But this method we are not going to write simply like this. What we will do is we will put this method inside another module and we will import that module here. So let's say I am creating a database module and I will have a method there for root. This is my own method. I mean, database module is my own module, not type or a module. And inside that I am passing these entities, all the entities we have, because this game is all about the entities, because initializing the database connection for all the entities which we have inside the entities folder. Okay, second is a type ORM module which we already have, so we don't need to worry about. We need to write this database module in our application. And here, because I'm saying this is advanced course, we are not just going to do database module.for root and put everything, username equal to process.env username, but we can think about dynamic initialization of this module using some method. Okay, so we can create a database module. Here is our database, and inside database module it will have the same structure. It's a simple class and we'll define all the methods. So let's say we have module and inside module what we are going to have, it's a simple class, export class database module, and inside this we can have a lot of private methods because we are going to get the connection options. But before that we are going to have one method which is private static for root, sorry, public, because we are calling this from another module. For root, we will customize this method based on our need. And what we are getting? We are getting some entities, right? So let's say we are going to create an interface for this, dbconfig. So don't just pass the key value or any. We can create a custom interface inside our database folder. db.interface.ts, and here it is a simple interface we have. This interface is saying we are passing all the connection options, all the entities array. So we can import this, import connection. So this is the dbconfig we are putting it here, and we will import it here in the dbconfig. And now we will do the dynamic initialization of this module. How we do this? We have this database module db.module.ts, and we have written this for root method inside it. Now we can use the type ORM module only inside it. So this is the public method, and this is a dynamic module. So we have to actually, I mean, it will return a dynamic module that we will add later. And what it is going to return is, this is going to return a module which is name is the same class name. I mean, this is how we write a dynamic module in the Next.js. And imports, what all things we are importing. So we are importing type ORM module, type ORM module, and we will use the method here, the dynamic initialization method of type ORM module here, which is type ORM module dot for root. We'll call the for root method for root async, because we are doing async initialization, not directly for root. And here we'll do a lot of things. So here, do we need to import any particular module? If you have the import dependency, like any custom logger modules you have and something like that. Otherwise, use factory. Inside use factory, you will provide a dependency if you have anything. Otherwise, you will call directly a method of this particular module. We will define a method here, database module dot get connection option. Database module dot get connection option. Get connection options, and we'll pass the db config which we have received, which is like array of all the entities which we wanted to pass while creating a database connection. And then, do we need to inject any particular service? Currently we are not looking for, but if you have any other module dependency here, then you can specify this, like config service. You can import the config service here and then provide the dependency injection. Now, get connection option. This is a method we are going to write, which can be a private static. Okay, private static get connection option. We are getting the db config as an input, which is nothing but a array of all the entities. So this is what we are taking, and what this method should return. This method should return the connection options, right? Type ORM connection option, which contains the based on the type, what we are looking for, the MySQL, Postgres, or something else, right? So we'll create one variable, and what we are going to do is simply return get connection option is another method we are going to write. So database module dot get connection options Postgres. I mean, what you can do is you can just check the type here. You can just also pass the type with the config, and based on the type you can write a particular method for MySQL, Postgres, MongoDB and all. Here I'm doing simply return database module const options of type. This should be of type, I think, type ORM connections. Let's say for now any. And we are going to write this method. So this can also be a private static connection options. And it will just simply look into the database and give us all the type ORM options. Okay, type ORM module options it should return. We'll clean this up. Okay, and what it will return simply is a few things about our database. I'll just say, because I'm using the database connection URL, so this database connection URL can come from process.env.connection URL, and how we are going to populate that in the process env, that's a different thing. But this is going to return type or module options that we can import. Okay, now finally what we are going to return from this is an object, right? So what that object will contain: all the entities, all the connection options which we have received. Okay, entities, all the entities we have received, which is a db config dot entities. Dot entities, and there are more custom fields like synchronize. Synchronize, like you wanted to synchronize database after each and every restart of the container or restart of the process, then it will actually look into the entities and it will try to synchronize. So these fields are important. Logging, if you wanted to log the SQL queries. So this is going to return these options. Why it's complaining? Export module. Okay, we have created this one. We'll clean this up. So here, now this database get connection option is giving us all the values which we need. This should return a type ORM connection options. Okay, we are returning this object. This object is directly being passed here, right? So it's like a dynamic initialization of database module we have. And we are passing the type Postgres. Here it can be MySQL, and we are using this URL. URL contains like localhost, Postgres colon, username, password, port, and all these things together. We don't need to pass each and every parameter separately, like username, password. There is a URL option. You can just pass the type and URL, that is enough. You don't need to pass all these individual arguments. Other options are also there, like keep connection alive and SSL options, which is like true or false. And there is a keep connection alive, I think. So these all things also you can get from the process environment. Okay, so this is pretty much. Now what you do is, we have created this database module. This database module can be imported in our main module, and we are calling for root method from there, passing all the entities array, and we are doing a dynamic initialization of type RM module. This is like use factory, get connection option. It will give us this particular object, which is having all the database options, entities. I mean, directly, indirectly, we are doing the same thing. We are passing entities, all the connection options, synchronize and logging. It's just a matter that how we do it. Dbconfig, I can import these things. I think these are missing, that's why it is complaining. Okay. So this is pretty much about this. Now what we do is, we have this entity module. We just import this database module. Here, things are good. So once the application starts, right, it will try to connect to the database. If everything is fine, database is connected. Now we can write our services and controllers, where services will talk to the database entities, like get, find, update, delete, all these things. Okay. So that's all about the type ORM integration with any of the database. Now here, type can be your MySQL, type can be your MySQL, Postgres and all. Other thing is, you also need to manage the ormconfig.ts. So ormconfig is another file which will maintain your migrations and all. So if you wanted to run the type ORM migrations, I think it's not here. We'll just see that in the next video, in the next template. So here, if you see the package.json, we can use this type ORM CLI commands, db generate, create, revert, sync, all these things. Okay, like how to write type ORM migrations, how to generate type ORM tables just by writing the entities, all these things are possible with this. Okay, thanks everyone.